No. Because it's the pet insurance side of Nationwide. Yeah, no, but that was the only thing that I did to get discharged from my insurance. And it was like, when you said this word, it's like, I was like, so, but that came part of the diagnosis. So we had it on there, and then I listened between voice as one plane, right? So everything became a separate plane.
You're not actually. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Maybe the cold revived her.
Don't anybody move.
Fussy's loose.
And Elsa, we saw you half naked and dead fall from the closet into Bernice's arms.
Oh, Bernice. Oh.
Perhaps it was someone else. I was in the basement gathering potatoes for the vicious swats.
She's still out there. Dead.
Who is dead?
Elsa, have you a twin?
Yeah, two. I am of triplets, sisters, but they are in Germany.
Elsa, someone who looks very like you was murdered here this afternoon.
I will look.
Come this way.
My Mutter und Vater worked in Berlin as laborers in the government printing plant. In 1923, they died. When a carton which contained marks, the equivalent of $5, fell on them and they were crushed. My sisters and I were raised by relatives. We saw each other only on Weihnachtsabend when we met to decorate the Weihnachtsbaum and give out Weihnachtsgeschenke.
Gesundheit.
My point is, I did not know my sisters.
That woman is absolutely no sense of humor.
Does Elsa accompany you out of town during Manhattan holiday?
No, Elsa was here at the house.
My gosh, identical triplets, a homicidal maniac, secret passages.
Yeah, it's beginning to look like one of those Hollywood mysteries you direct, Mr. Dale Mays.
I didn't know you had directed a mystery, Ken.
One, Murder at the Biltmore, with William Powell, Myrna Loy, Sidney Blackmer, Ralph Bellamy, Nat Pendleton, Louise Upton, and Alicia Cook Jr.
Has that been released?
No, have you seen it?
I think so.
I don't think she looks a thing like me.
But Elsa!
She's the spitting image!
Elsa, was either of your sisters a ballet dancer by any chance?
Dances! Gott in Himmel, no! Hilda lives in Strusslin, working in a boatyard making sails. Hilda lives in Stuttgart, where she waits tables at Biergarten. Now, if you will excuse me, I must get back to the dinner.
You're saying that's not your sister out there?
Anything is possible, but I believe my sister to be in Germany.
That woman out there is an exact likeness.
My grossfather was a merchant seaman out of Bremen. Perhaps he put ashore in Brooklyn. It is only a train ride to here. Nicht wahr? Mr. O'Reilly is dead also?
We don't know.
See, I told you she had eyes for two murders and all she's concerned for was O'Reilly.
Obviously, Elsa's lying, though I can't imagine why.
She's covering for him.
I thought espionage was in your blood.
It is. It's just a little sluggish at the moment.
Maybe one of her sisters was on her way here and was killed before Elsa knew she arrived.
Then why would she identify?
Perhaps Elsa's sister is the slasher?
If her sister is the slasher, then who slashed her?
It's all too confusing.
No, it's simple. Look, you got a sister who's a servant in Chappaqua, a sister selling sausage and sauerkraut in Stuttgart, and a sister selling sales somewhere.
Strusslin.
So, either Helga from Stuttgart or Hilda from Strusslin seeking her sister in a snowstorm in a swankiest cooked section of Chappaqua is hacked by a homicidal hacker who thinks Hilda or Helga is Elsa. Now ask yourself, why?
Ask myself why? I don't even know what you just said.
Ask myself why what?
Not why what, why who?
Why who what? No, not why who what. Why? Why who what why?
What?
Because before you ask who, you have to ask why.
And how.
How what?
I was just agreeing. And how.
Maybe it depends on when.
When what?
Please, if you're going to do that again, I need another drink.
Let me see that book.
Could Elsa be the slasher? Well, it's what we're all thinking, right?
Of course it's what we're all thinking, but why would Elsa murder three women?
Jealousy.
Of who?
Of your friends. You said you had many.
I said Phoebe had many.
Really, Roger, if you're going to take the thoughts of others and twist them, I prefer you stick to Jerome Kerr. You do them so much better.
I do not steal from Jerome Kerr.
He certainly does not.
Thank you, Bernice.
It's Sigmund Romberg.
Oh, fine. Let's all be viciously funny of my talent. It strikes me as an exceptionally transparent attempt to get us off the subject, which is, which one of us might have had a motive?
All right, then. Shall we begin with the well-known fact that you hate dancers?
Not true. I only hate them when they sing.
You did demand those three girls be removed from the numbers.
But not with a knife!
And our live streamers. Thank you to our live streamers watching from home. Hello, Grandma and Grandpa. And so, we'd like to now take a brief moment to thank everyone who made this evening possible. The Powell parents and staff, Karen Dan Schubert, Colleen Colston, Alan Carl Arano, the Development Department, our sponsors, Ambassador Wine for Washington, Boss Water, and Precept Wine. Thank you.
I want to say, I'm Mr. Van Dyne, and I'm the band director here. I'm a little early. I know it's before Thanksgiving. It is a Christmas song. I'm sorry. Saxophone class, I gave them this quintet piece, and I was like, let's see how it sounds, let's see how it goes. And they really, really took it under their wing. I thought it sounded really nice. So give them one more round of applause.
Well, I gotta say, I think that talented quintet majors have been a little too
sexy for this crowd. Seriously, Miss Dar, did you write this? Dad jokes. Dead giveaway. Moving on, I have the pleasure to introduce our next performer, Senior Ava Romana, here to sing Time's Not Hard for Dreamers from the musical Amelie.
Thank you.
Alrighty, we our second tune.
Oh, second one. Not yet.
Go ahead. Thank you very much.
Oh, Caught her red-handed, hand in stocking, assorted trinkets in other hand, no room for explanation. So at 8, no Santa. He's dead to me. So I know this, fact, there is no Santa. But even after that, even after I knew, I wanted so badly to believe in Santa that I tricked myself. For 3 years, I tricked myself. And now, we're here. But that's not all. You ready? Here goes. I love you, Gab. I really do. When we started dating and all that, I thought things would change, that I would become attracted to who I'm supposed to be attracted to, but that didn't happen, and I am sorry. But I love you, in spite of me, I love you, because you are the best person I know. The best, and there's no denying that you are the best. I never would have planned this, not in a million years, because that would make me slime. You have to believe that. But if there were to be a person, a girl, no, a woman, it would be you. And I don't mean that in some sort of cereal box, consolation prize sort of way, but in a way that's as real as anything I can ever say. If there was, it would be you. Does that make sense? Thank you.
Seriously, great performance, Rob. Now, speaking of thespians. Hello, my name is Isaac Stevens, and I am the thespian council president here at Bishop Blanchet for thespian troop 5342. I got the number right. That's good. It's a good thing. Okay. So, therefore, it's my great honor to announce that this year, our thespian troop is going to be participating and competing in the thespies. Yeah! So, yeah, this is the first time that our thespian troop has ever done this. And now, what are the thespies? Well, I have this handy little sheet right here telling me. The International Thespian Excellence Awards, also known as the thespies, are an educational program designed to provide constructive feedback for thespians to improve their prepared theatrical materials, expand their performance and technical expertise, and develop their professional and presentation skills. The program includes 16 categories, spanning from performance to technical theater to filmmaking and writing. Each entry is adjudicated by theater educators and professionals based on rubrics that reflect national standards in the theater education. Wow, a lot of big words in that. Basically, it's a national competition. It's think like in sports terms, for you sports terms out there, think like state speed for varsity. You know, it's kind of, it's the big thing. There's districts, there's state, there's nationals, all those levels, and it sounds like an amazing opportunity for all thespians. But dig this, you don't have to be a thespian to participate. So, you can, if students who are listening are interested, there's the drama hall board outside the drama office has loads of information. Also, you can ask Ms. Star, our drama director, and also our adult thespian head. Another thing I have on our meeting, which is not related to thespian at all, is the improv team. So, we love making stuff up, because that's what we do in improv. We make stuff up on the fly, and we love to make some stuff up for you tonight. So if I could have to the stage, welcome and joining on stage, a Noah Lechenwell, Rachel Browning, Christine Hanglett, Josephine Partridge, and our professional theater, professional improv supervisor, Mrs. Partridge, who would like to share a few words about improv.
These are very great thespians who are making things up on the spot using your audience suggestions. They haven't prepared anything other than showing up. So they listen well, they agree with each other, and they make scenes, and it's magic. This particular group, I just wanted to give them a little shout out. When we had to shut down because of quarantine and we went online, these players showed up every week, and they even developed a separate improv collaborative show called Improv, Blanchet News. If you've seen Blanchet News show, they would do stories about what's going on in the high school and then a brief little sketch. And I just want to have you please give them a hand for their dedication to improv. Even though they're calling them. Thank you. That's all I have to say, and speak up because you're not on your cameras at home.
Thank you. I'm Josephine Carter, co-captain of Improv with Isaac. And we're excited to give a little show for you tonight. We're
going to
be playing a game. Would you like to explain?
Yeah, so this game, there are many names for this game. I like to call it Last Line. So basically, there's going to be two scenes on stage. And one is going to get going, and then they're going to say a line that the other scene really likes, and they're going to clap their hands. And then whoever clapped their hands from the other scene is going to say that line, but incorporate it in a way that makes sense in their scene that they are creating out of their brains. So it's a little complicated, but once we get it going, I'm sure it'll start to make sense.
Two suggestions from the audience. Can I get a location? Any location?
I think I ate too many pancakes.
I'm
just not as spry as I was 30 years ago.
Well, you only ate one pancake.
One? That's it?
It
was a great pancake.
It was good.
Oh, gosh.
Blueberry, your favorite.
Oh, no, I don't feel so good.
Was it the buckwheat?
Was there buckwheat in there?
We told you not to go healthy.
Oh no, I don't like the buckwheat.
Oh, did you bring your Pepto-Bismol?
Oh, it's in my purse, my man purse.
Your man purse?
My man purse.
Is it the green one?
Yeah, the green one with the white stripes.
Okay.
The green one with the white stripes? Can I try that trumpet, please?
Yes, this is our most expensive model. Are you sure you want to try this one?
Yes.
Okay, handle it with care.
I think you need to work on your buffering job.
Why do you say that?
Well, I see some smudges.
No, she doesn't. There are no smudges.
Did you smudge the trumpet, Marceline?
No, of course not. I am very dedicated to my...
Well, I don't want to play this expensive trumpet unless it is buffered correctly.
Do you hear that, Marceline? She doesn't want to play with that expensive trumpet unless it's buffered. Sorry about that, man.
God, I should really take a job at McDonald's.
Anything else?
Whoever baked my pancake should take a job at McDonald's. It's not.
Yes.
It's not the job.
We will make sure to complain to them.
Oh, where's my cane? Oh, I need my cane.
Get his cane!
Oh, God. Why did you let go of me, children?
I'm sorry.
I'm a flip. I'm a
out of your pores.
I'm a pale, frail old man.
It's okay, Grandpa
Joe. Where's my cane?
It's right here.
Thank you. Oh, man. Oh, I can feel the buckwheat working.
Do I need to make it to the bathroom?
We might need to get there.
All right.
Okay.
Server, where's the nearest bathroom?
Restroom.
Excuse me, this is all taking a toll on me. I know I work here, but where's the nearest bathroom, Marceline? It's dire.
I think, down the hall. Left, but not that left. You have to take the other left, and then there's a left after that, but then after that you have to go through right, round the corner, and then there's kind of a weird concentric circle there. You gotta run up I think, 3, 4, 5 floors, and then you have to take another left.
You mean we have to go up 3 floors to get to the bathroom?
What?
Are you serious?
Do you see me, young man?
Do you see
the state I'm in?
You mean there's no elevator?
Are you serious?
You could not afford an elevator.
You're an IHOP. Don't you get all those young theater folks in here all the time?
There probably got too many lawsuits from you, Grandpa.
Oh, that's true. I do lawsuit them a lot, yeah.
That is true. I do lawsuit them a lot, but they were not running good businesses, and none of the trumpets were shining.
Please, ma'am, you gotta understand. I know I left before, but we have a shiny trumpet right here for you.
Show me.
A shiny trumpet there.
A shiny, brand new trumpet.
My! I like it already. Let's see how it plays. I love it. My hands. How much is it?
How much is it? There's a fare for the elevator.
The fare for the elevator?
Grandpa, there's a push-out sign.
Waffle House.
For the end.
Yes.
So we're gonna, take
yeah.
a 5 minute.
Yes.
One last little applause and bow for the improv team.
Hey.
No. Congratulations, the rule where I got to sing, but also got to sit down a lot. That's why all the parent alumni clapped so loudly when I walked out. This is the song where you can cough. So everybody get those coughs out. Or you can whisper, what's the time? Where are we eating after this? Maybe we should just do takeout. Is this song even on the soundtrack? Not sure, you skip it every time.
But Jesus, this song.
Roman, now that we're friends, I decided to make you my new project.
You really don't have to do that.
I know. That's what makes me so nice. Watch this. That's what makes me so nice. Whenever I see someone less fortunate than I, and let's face it, who is it? Less fortunate than I, my tender heart tends to start to bleed. And when someone needs a makeover, I simply have to take over. I know exactly what they need. And even in your case, though it's the toughest case I've yet to face, don't worry, I'm determined to succeed. Follow my lead, and yes, indeed, you will be popular. You're gonna be popular. I'll teach you the ways to twirl when you dance with girls, little ways to flirt and clout. I'll show you what shoes to wear, how to fix that hair, everything that really wants to be popular. I'll help you be popular. You'll hang with the right cohorts. You'll be good at sports. Know the slang you've got to know. So let's start, cause you've got an awfully long way to go. Think of it as personality dialysis. Not a lot of choice to become a pal, brother, an advisor. There's nobody wiser, not when it comes to popular. I'll help you be popular, and with an assist for me to be who you'll be instead of dreary dreamer. R, there's nothing that can stop you from becoming popular. Lar, la, la. Depressing creatures with unprepossessing features, I remind them on their own we have to wake up. Celebrate heads of state, or especially great communicators. Did they have brains or knowledge? Don't make you laugh. They were popular. It's all about popular. It's not about aptitude. It's the way you're viewed. So it's very shrewd to be very, very popular, like me. There you are. I think you were the spitting image of the most popular guy in school. Me, naturally. I have to go. You're welcome. And though you protest your disinterest, I know clandestinely you're gonna grin and bear it. You knew about popularity. Yeah! La 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 di da da. You'll be popular, just not quite as popular as me.
Thank you.
I was just milking that up so slow and so sweet. I loved it. And, you know, it's not really a dancing song, but it has like these, I like to dance, you know? I like to get a little boogie out, you know? So, and in the nights like these, I feel like I could dance straight through to the morning. I could dance all night. And you know who else can? Josephine Parker, who happens to be singing, I could have danced all night. So please, see if Josephine Parker can go away.
Thank you. grand drink. I say in a nice deep green almond flavor, but with a much darker color.
Rises to reveal our students. Look at them on stage, choirs and bands and orchestras and ceremonies and award assemblies.
Play.
The spring musical. All of it right there and all right here. Can't you picture it? Can you picture it? Can you? It's so beautiful. It's time. It's time for a theater right here on campus. Those who can't attend in person, there's also a Zoom option as well. To participate in this meeting, you can check your last weekly update or check in with one of us on your way out. We'll give it to you. There is a link there to join us. So do join us. Let's get our students on our stage.
Oh,
That they played the cadence as we came in. They also just played Hot Wings. And we had solos from Lukasz Uniak. And solos from Jake Law. And I believe we're playing ranch sauce. Yes? Yes, yep. Why, because you have Hot Wings, need some ranch sauce.
magic of musical theater. Full in front of her. She is so